We present today a case of EUS-guided pancreatic radiofrequency for the treatment of a grade 1 juxta-centimetric neuroendocrine tumor, discovered incidentally in a young patient who requested treatment rather than monitoring. The treatment decision is validated beforehand in a multidisciplinary meeting, and the diagnosis is proven histologically thanks to the FNA performed during the initial echoendoscopy. The elastographic analysis is not typical of a NTE, this case with a non-indurated tumor. The procedure is performed under deep sedation, with antibiotic prophylaxis and systematic administration of NSAIDs. The US appearance of the lesion is more characteristic with a very hypoechoic, rounded and well-defined lesion. The NET is located on the posterior side of the body of the pancreas. It is important to locate main pancreatic duct, MPD, and its distance from the lesion. In this case, the MPD is of normal caliber and very close contact, less than 2 mm, with the NET. We will perform the treatment using a 19-gauge EUS-RA needle combined with a Viva combo radiofrequency generator. The needle is then connected to the radio frequency generator, set to the power of 50 watts. Two plates are previously glued to the patient's thighs. A water irrigation channel aimed at cooling the needle . Once all the connections have been made, the actual radiofrequency ablation can begin. We apply a first pulse of 8 seconds, interrupted when ultrasound signs of boiling appear, or in the event of a generator impedance warning signal. The radiofrequency current is delivered along the tip of the needle, then repositioned to treat the entire lesion. The first impact here makes the lesion already difficult to visualize. A second pulse is delivered, interrupted again when signs of boiling appear. The needle is again repositioned for a third pulse. a more diffuse boiling along the needle is then observed. The destruction seeming complete, the needle is then withdrawn. You can inject Sonoview contrast agent at the end of the examination, not used in this case. The patient presented with light acute pancreatitis delayed for more than 24 hours. Probably favored by the proximity to the MPD duct and the small size of the lesion. Monitoring is based on EUS coupled with abdominal MRI at 6 months. Het du Tartoc is facultative in our practice. 30% of NETS treated by pancreatic radiofrequency require a second session. Usually performed at 3 months. Literature data report 60 to 86% of complete response.